Before we begin the most interesting part of this session, that is question and answer session, our honorable chief guest Sayyid Umar Jalil Sahab will address the gathering.
Respected Majid Sahab, Mr. Zubair, Mr. Imran, ladies and gentlemen, as usual, I wish you assalamu alaikum and namaskar. I do it in all my regular speeches also. If you say assalamu alaikum, you don't become a Muslim. If I say namaste, I don't become a Hindu. These are things which help us in understanding each other. And I sincerely believe all my actions will reflect on my community. So I try to do them most sincerely. I was very much interested and intrigued by the topic, and I wanted to come here and speak, though I am not a scholar, I have not read much, but I claim to be a general human being like you and me, and I feel it my duty as a member of the Islamic faith to put forth before the others of my countrymen, so that it will help you in understanding what Islam is, why people behave in a certain way, and what compels them to do this and other things. Today, definitely, our friend Mr. Imran has clearly expounded to you, tried to explain to you what jihad means. And I dare say he has made it very clear what jihad means. Jihad is struggle against evil, struggle against oppression, struggle against one's desires, and struggle against what is ungodly in the common language. So, as he has also mentioned, there have been many books written by non-Muslims, by a set of mindset which tried to portray Muslims as people who are engaged in warfare, as people who are engaged in propagating their religion by the sword or the gun. For the Muslims or for anybody else, Prophet Muhammad is the only perfect example of how a Muslim should be. He has led his life and shown us what it means to be a Muslim, how a Muslim should lead his life in this world. He has never waged war. He was only attacked every time. He was persecuted in Makkah. He has never retaliated. And when he went away to Medina, the people from Makkah used to come regularly and attack him. He has not gone and attacked. And in the only time he went and conquered Makkah, there also our brother has clearly pointed out, you can see the records also, there was no bloodshed, Makkah was taken. And on that day he announced clear amnesty, mafi to all those people who had killed Muslims, who had persecuted the Prophet personally, who had done social boycott to him, who had killed all other Muslims also, just because they professed a particular religion. Still, he has forgiven them. That is what a Muslim should behave in all times. Jihad has also been clearly mentioned here. But in today's life, in India and elsewhere in the world, we see a lot of people who are doing deeds in the name of Islam, in the name of religion, which do not form part of any teaching of any Islam anywhere in the world. In the name of Islam, they say jihad. Jihad, as your brother has pointed out, it has got nothing to do with jihad. They are only propagating their self-interest or their misguided understanding. killing innocent being, killing innocent people, either here or anywhere, cannot be jihad. It is not jihad. Cannot be permitted by Islam. Is not permitted by Islam. Whatever they are doing murders. They are killing innocent people. They are going to be held responsible. It is time people like you and me, people who profess to be Muslims, we should stand up, we should speak up, and let people also know that Muslims do not want any killing, Muslims do not condone any killing, Muslims do not support any kind of killing in the name of Islam. Some fellows carrying out that. It is also true that because of these persons, because of these misguided fellows, the whole community gets a bad name. I am saying this as a Muslim. I am not telling you as this a joint collector. Main koi sarkari musalman nahi hu. But it is time, every time things like Akshardham, things like Varanasi blast, things like attack on the Ram Janma Bhumi take place, lot of people keep on asking, why don't Muslims condemn this thing? If I say that, will you print it in the newspaper? Who am I? Nobody. But some fellows who talk rubbish, who talk against the Islam, their things, whatever they say, is printed very clearly. Some harkat jihad ul Islam is something they say, they take Muslim names. They say, we'll do this, we'll do that, we are doing this in the name of Islam, we are doing jihad. That gets printed in all the newspapers, in all the channels it comes. So, it is time all of us, Hindus and Muslims, Muslims should stand up and speak up, whether you agree with the behavior which certain people are carrying out. Secondly, Hindus also and non-Muslims, not just Hindus, non-Muslims, they should also understand, if a particular set of people are doing it for a particular set of objectives, which are basically political, Kashmir or Pakistan, the fight between India and Pakistan is basically political, it's not religious. So, if somebody is doing that, the whole community cannot be held responsible for that act. Can it be? If somebody is doing some mischief in Ayodhya, can all the whole Hindu community be held responsible for that? So whatever is happening in Kashmir, can all the Muslims be held responsible for that? We should all speak up. There are some people are being misguided, are being used by certain foreign people. They don't know their religion. They are misguiding people. People who don't know their own religion are being misguided. So it is time all of us stood up, all of us spoke up, and all of us should condemn this kind of activity. In the name of jihad, terrorists are carrying out terrorist activities. That is not Islam. Similarly, other activities which take place, let us say for example, in Sri Lanka, there is a fight between Tamils and the Sinhala people there. We don't call it Hindu terrorism, we don't call it Buddhist terrorism if they fight among each other. Similarly, there is a fight in Bosnia-Herzegovina. It was not a fight between Hindus and between Muslims and Christians. It was basically a political fight, a fight of cultures and other things. So basically, political things are there which people try to use religion in their name and try to make advantage of that, try to make capital of that. Fortunately or unfortunately, Muslims are ruled not by their mind but by their heart. Jazbati log hote hain. They get misguided easily. It is for all of us, each of us, to stand up to say what is wrong is wrong. That way, when we live in this city, when we live in this country, we should have the confidence of each of us living together. We have been here for centuries. We have chosen this to be our country. We had this choice, very bad choice in 1947. Some fellows went away. Those who have chosen to stay here have chosen to stay here out of love of this country or whatever it is. We have chosen to stay here. We are as much citizens of this country as anybody else. So let us love, cherish, and protect this country. and also protect the fair name of the religion you profess, because that's the religion of peace. Thank you.
Before we begin the most interesting part of session, that is question and answer session, CIS shall present a gift to Honorable Chief Guest of this session. I request Janab Abdul Majid Sahab, Secretary, Bluebirds Educational Society, to hand over a gift to Janab Sayyid Umar Jalil Sahab.
I'd like to take leave of you. I cannot continue here because some urgent work is there, as you are all aware. Honorable Chief Minister is coming tomorrow. So certain works are there, I need to go. But kindly continue, he will be there. Question and answers. Definitely many more questions will be there. And many more answers are there. So kindly interact. Please permit me to go. Thank you. Good night.
Now we shall begin most interesting part of the session, that is question and answer session. To derive maximum benefit out of the limited time available, I request the questioners to follow certain rules. 2 mics have been provided in the lecture hall, one for brothers and other for sisters. Before posing the question, the questioner has to tell his or her name so as to make it convenient for the speaker to answer according to the background of questioner. Questions only pertaining to the topic will be allowed. Questions out of the topic will not be entertained. Only one question at a time is allowed. If the questioner has the second question, he or she has to go back in the queue and wait for his or her second chance. Question on cheats will not be entertained. Please keep your question short and clear. And first question from brother's side. Non-Muslims will be given preference.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam.
जैसे अभी जिहाद एंड टेररिज्म के ऊपर हुई, मुझे इंग्लिश ज़्यादा नहीं आती है, लेकिन मैं उर्दू में मैं क्वेश्चन करूँगा. जैसे जिहाद की तारीफ की गई कि जिहाद के मीनिंग है कोशिश करना, यानी अल्लाह के रास्ते में कोशिश करना. और जैसे कश्मीर है, फिलिस्तीन है, चेचनिया है, बोसनिया है, तो जो लोग अब जैसे जुल्म हो रहा है, जैसे आप मीडिया, प्रिंट मीडिया, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया जो आप देखते हैं उसको, कि एक बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट करता है फिर उसके जवाब में होता है, तो जो लोग अपने दिफा के लिए जो बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट कर रहे हैं अपने बचाव के लिए, अपने देश को, अपनी सरजमीन को बचाने के लिए, वहाँ के लोगों को बचाने के लिए, तो इसको हम क्या कहेंगे? इसको उन लोगों को जो अपनी दिफा के लिए जो बम ब्लास्ट करते हैं या खुदकशी करते हैं, इसको हम टेररिस्ट बोलेंगे? या उन लोगों को जो ये कर रहे हैं अपने बचाव के लिए, उसके ऊपर जो ज्यादतियाँ कर रहे हैं, उसको हम रिलीजियन कहेंगे या इसको हम टेररिस्ट कहेंगे? ये चीज़ नहीं समझ में आ रही, ये चीज़.
जज़ाकअल्लाह खैर, आपने अच्छा सवाल किया है. मैं अपने तकरीर के दौरान मैंने बताया कि जिहाद में जब कोई हम पर हमला करता है और जब हम अपनी बचाव के लिए हम बचाव करते हैं और हमारे बचाव करने के दौरान वो मर जाता है, तो इसको इस्लाम ने जिहाद कहा है. और दुनिया का कानून, हिंदुस्तान का कानून इसको जुर्म नहीं मानता. ہندوستان کا قانون ہو یا کوئی اور دنیا کا قانون ہو اور اللہ کا قانون بھی, جب ہم پر کوئی حملہ کرے اور ہم اپنے خود کے بچاؤ کے لیے کوئی اقدام اٹھائیں اور اس اقدام اٹھانے کی وجہ سے حملہ آور مر جائے تو اس کو جہاد کہا گیا ہے.
آپ
نے سوال کیا, میں نے جواب ختم نہیں کیا. تو آپ نے پوچھا کہ جو لوگ بوم بلاسٹ کر رہے ہیں یا یہ جو کچھ بھی کر رہے ہیں ان کے بارے میں کیا کہا جائے گا. اس تعلق سے دیکھیے, آپ ہو یا میں ہو یا ہم سب مسلمان ہو, ہمارا بنیادی ایمان کیا ہے کہ ہم اسلام کو اسی انداز میں پیش کریں گے جس کی اجازت قرآن اور رسول اکرم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے ہم کو دی ہے. سورہ نساء سورہ نمبر 4 آیت نمبر 83, سورہ نمبر 4 آیت نمبر 83, اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ فرماتے ہیں کہ جب تمہارے پاس کوئی اسلام کا معاملہ لے کر آئے, مسئلے مسائل کا, تو اس معاملے کو ان کو چاہیے کہ رسول اکرم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے پاس پھیریں یا اس معاملے کے ماہر کے پاس پھیر دیں. تو اس اعتبار سے اگر میں ایکسپرٹ ہوں, میں ماہر ہوں غیر مسلم کو یہ سمجھانے میں کہ دیکھو اسلام دہشت گردی کی تعلیم نہیں دیتا, لیکن ایک مسئلے پہ کہ ان کو کیا کہا جائے, اس مسئلے کے لیے اگر مجھے بھی یہ سوال آئے گا تو میں سورہ نساء کی آیت نمبر 83 کے مطابق علماء سے رجوع ہوں گا. شیخ حتیمین ایک سعودی کے عالم تھے جس کا انتقال ہو گیا ہے, ان کے پاس یہ مسئلہ لے جایا گیا تھا. جب شیخ حتیمین کو اس مسئلے پر پوچھا گیا تو انہوں نے کہا کہ جو آدمی خودکش بندستہ بنتا ہے, وہ خودکشی کر لے رہا ہے اپنی دفاع کے لیے, اس کے بارے میں ہم اپنی زبان پر خاموشی اختیار کریں گے, نہ ہم اس کو شہید کہیں گے نہ کہیں گے کہ اس نے خودکشی کی ہے, ہم اللہ سے دعا کریں گے کہ اے اللہ اس کی مغفرت فرما دے. لیکن کوئی آ کے اگر مجھ سے سوال کرے, میں نے کر رہا ہوں شیخ حتیمین کا, دہرا رہا ہوں آپ کے سامنے فتویٰ, ایک شیخ حتیمین عالم تھے, اب ہو سکتا ہے کہ انہوں نے صحیح فتویٰ دیا آپ کے مطابق نہیں دیا. شیخ حتیمین نے کہا کوئی مجھ سے آ کر پوچھے کہ اب میں خودکشی بندستہ بننا چاہتا ہوں تو ہم اس کو کہیں گے کہ اسلام میں اس کی اجازت نہیں ہے. اب اس کے باوجود بھی آپ کے پاس یہ مسئلہ باقی ہے تو آپ ضرور علماء سے رجوع ہوئیے, آپ کو علماء مسئلے مسائل پر حق رکھتے ہیں کہ فتوی دیں. میں آپ کے سامنے میرا علم بتا دیا, میں نہ فتویٰ دیا آپ کے سامنے, نہ آپ کو یہ بتایا کہ آپ غلط مجھ سے سوال کر رہے ہیں, نہ میں شیخ حتیمین کے بارے میں کہا کہ انہوں نے صحیح کہا یا غلط کہا. آپ نے ایک سوال پوچھا, میں نے ایک وقت کے عالم کا ایک جواب آپ کے سامنے پیش کیا. اب آپ کی مرضی ہے, آپ ایسے اگر قبول کرتے ہیں قبول کیجئے, نہیں کرتے ہیں تو وقت کے علماء سے رجوع ہوئیے اس مسئلے کے لیے, وہ لوگ انشاءاللہ آپ کو حل دیں گے. امید آپ کا جواب ہو گیا.
نیکسٹ کوشچن فرام سسٹر سائٹ.
السلام علیکم.
وعلیکم السلام.
میں رانا ہوں. ایز اٹ از سیڈ دیٹ فالو آن رائٹ پاتھ اینڈ گیو اے چانس فار اے کنٹری ٹو فالو آن رائٹ پاتھ, اف دے ڈو ناٹ ایکسیپٹ گیو ادر چانس, ایون دو اف دے ڈو ناٹ ایکسیپٹ اٹ از دین سیڈ دیٹ کل آل دا میلس آف دیٹ پلیس, کل آل دا فیمیلس آف دیٹ پلیس, کل آل دا میل چائلڈ آف دیٹ پلیس, بٹ ڈونٹ کل دا فیمیل چائلڈ, وائی ناٹ؟
Sister has asked a question that I told in my talk, that it is mentioned that if you attack a country, then give them a chance of peace. Sister, actually, if you were carefully listening, I was quoting the Bible. It is mentioned in the Bible, in the Old Testament, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 20, verse number 10 to verse number 18, where book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 20, verse number 10 to 18, it commands the Jews, if you want to attack a country, offer a chance of peace for them. What should be the chance of peace? Tell them that all your family members should become our slaves, ہمارے غلام بن جانا. If they agree, it's fine. If they don't agree, attack them, kill all their males, kill all the women who have known a man, meaning who are married to somebody, kill all the male children and let only female children and the virgins remain, so that you use them for yourself. Sister has asked a question, why is it mentioned so? Sister, in fact, this is a question that we are asking the Jewish scholars to explain us, that you people are saying Quran teaches terrorism, there cannot be a worse terrorism than this verse anywhere, which says let the virgins and the female children be left behind, so that we use them for what? Use in what sense? So this is what we say, that alhamdulillah the Quran did not speak like this. The Quran never said that let the female children remain. Instead, the beloved Prophet Muhammad SAW was so eager in giving women's rights. He said that when you attack a country, see to it that you do not touch a woman and the children there, male and female children. As mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 4, hadith number 257, 258, 259 and 260, sister. In fact, this is a question that we Muslims would like to ask to the Jews to explain to us, still you follow this as the scripture, and you see, this is what they are doing in Palestine. This is what they are doing. They are killing the Palestinian Muslim males. They kill Muslim women who are elder. They just capture the girls there. This is how they are exploiting. As I already told in the beginning of my talk, unfortunately, the main strings of the media are in the hands of the doltish in the society, are in the hands of the stupids and idiots. And they are ruling the media. As Janab Umar Jalil Saab also said, that when the non-Muslims ask the question, why do you Muslims not condemn the actions of terrorism? When there is action of terrorism, the media very openly reports it. But when the scholars condemn it, it never comes as a news. So what should we do now? The option is, we should have our own media now. We should work for it. And then we should make it clear that we Muslims don't stand for terrorism. Sister, this is a question that we should honestly ask them, sister, that how can you still follow this to be the word of God, and how can this be a book of peace? This is what we would like to ask them, sister. I hope I answered your question.
Assalamu alaikum. In what way we do jihad in modern world? At the last, in your talk, at the last you said, with the weapon we can do, which weapon we prefer, I mean, which cannot kill women, children and old people. In what way we can do jihad in the modern world?
Yeah, brother has asked a very good question, that today there are weapons of mass destruction, WMDs, for which America attacked Iraq, saying Iraq has got WMDs, weapons of mass destruction. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded in Sahih al-Bukhari volume number 4, hadith number 257 to 260, that do not kill women and children. So now if we want to wage a war against any non-Muslim country, what weapons we should use to wage a war against this country, against these countries? In that hadith, when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not touch the women and children, he meant those women and children who did not come on the battlefield to fight you. But if the women have come out openly to fight you, you can't do anything now. Even they will be taken as enemies. It was for those women who are living back, staying back in their homes, who have not come out to fight the Muslim enemy. Now to kill these women who have come out to fight the Muslim army is not a crime in Islam, is not a sin in Islam. They can be killed. The weapons that we are using today, we all know that there are civilian targets and there are army targets. And always the army